Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will learn about the periodic table, how it's organized, and how to read it. Let's jump in. This is the periodic table of elements, and it's made up of, you got it, elements. Each one of the boxes that you see is a specific element. But what is an element? Elements are often known by another name you may have learned in one of your lessons, atoms. You might already know that atoms are the building blocks of life. They are super tiny, microscopic blocks of matter that can't be broken down into any smaller parts. Since atoms are so small, scientists have decided to make a table to keep track of them all. We're going to learn how this table is organized. Let's start with the basics. The periodic table is broken up into columns and rows, but to be tricky, scientists call them groups and periods. Groups go down like columns. For example, group 1 can be found here. Can you find group 14? Yep, right here. We keep similar elements in the same group, or groups. Periods go across like rows. For example, here is row 5. Can you find row 2? Yep, there are a lot of empty spaces in row 2. Now let's take a look into how the periodic table is organized. The periodic table is mostly made up of elements that are metals. In fact, 75% of the table is metals. We're going to start with group 1, way over here on the left side, but only the yellow boxes, period 2 through 7. These are called the alkali metals. This group is the most reactive group of elements on the table. They react a lot when they come in contact with water. Some of the elements can even explode. Now, let's zoom in on group 2. Right next to our alkali metals live our alkaline earth metals. Just like alkali metals, the alkaline earth metals live in periods 2 through 7. This is the second most reactive group of elements on the periodic table. They are very unstable and reactive elements, but they're less reactive than the alkali metals. Now we are going to look at the biggest set of elements on the table. All of these red boxes here that stretch from group 3 to group 12 are called the transitional metals. The transitional metals are metals, just like the alkali and alkaline earth metals. But the metals in group 3 to group 12 hold their electrons differently than any other elements on the table, and that is why they are called transitional. The dark teal boxes are called the post-transitional metals. Notice that they are grouped together after the transitional metals in groups 13 through 16 and periods 3 through 7. Sometimes scientists refer to the post-transition metals as poor metals. Compared to the transitional metals, the post-transition metals are softer and have a lower melting point, meaning they turn to liquid at lower temps. Let's check out these bottom rows now. First, we will take a peek into these pink boxes. If we follow the arrow up, it would appear that they technically belong in period 6. These are called lanthanides. The lanthanides are all metals that are found naturally occurring in the Earth's crust, but they are very rare on Earth. That means that they're hard to find, and there's not a lot of them that exist. Now, if we move below to the purple boxes, we will see that these belong in period 7. We call this group of elements the actinides. The actinides are found in the very bottom of the periodic table, and they also fall into the metal category, but most of them are man-made. That means they were created in a laboratory and cannot be found naturally on Earth. Now, what if something is sort of like a metal, but not exactly? That's what we call this staircase of elements in groups 13 through 17. These we call the metalloids. Metalloids are not metals, but they have a lot of the same properties as metals, and there are 7 of them on the periodic table. Over here in group 17, we have the halogens. They run from periods 2 to period 7. Halogens are not metals, but they are reactive, especially the top element. As you work your way down the periods, they become more stable. Halogens like to make bonds with elements from group 1, the alkali metals. We have another group that we refer to as other nonmetals, since the metalloids and the halogens are nonmetals as well, but also have their own specific categories. The other nonmetals are found in groups 14, 15, and 16. Other nonmetals are, you guessed it, not metals. But unlike metalloids, the other nonmetals do not have similar characteristics to metals, and they can exist in all 3 states of matter at room temperature. Now we're going to zoom in here on group 18, periods 1 through 6. These are called the noble gases. These noble gases are very stable and hardly ever react. What does it mean for an element to be stable? It means the nucleus is tightly held together with very strong bonds. Sometimes people refer to them as inert gases. Lastly, we're going to point out these gray boxes down here. These are called unknown elemental composition, and they're all in period 7. These elements in period 7 are all made by scientists in the lab, and most of them are metals and very unstable. So far, they're only used for research to help scientists understand how atoms work. Now, what does it look like if we zoom in on just one element? What do all those symbols mean? This is a super zoom on an element box for helium. Helium is a noble gas, so it goes in group 18 of the periodic table. We can tell that this is helium because the element name can be found down here at the bottom. But sometimes it's handy to have a short name for the elements. That is what these big letters in the element box are. We call it the element symbol. For helium, it's HE. Up in the left corner is the atomic number. It is called the atomic number because it represents how many protons are in the element's atom. How many protons does helium have? 2. And up here in the right corner, we have the atomic mass. The atomic mass is an average mass for each atom in any form that it takes. Well, look at you. Now when you look at this picture, you can identify each group on the periodic table and decode the boxes for each element. Great job! Now practice what you know by playing our online games and doing the online quizzes. And remember to always be clever! Hey, hey.